is on the way, and that means, yes, more salt out on the streets. Meteorologist Eric Zarn is joining me here now, and there are some big concerns here tonight about the impact all this salt could have on our environment.
Yeah, you know, when it comes to a winter like this, as salt is really a lifesaver, but those huge sheds of sodium chloride, they all end up in one place, our stream and our rivers. Morning, noon, and night. Our road departments work tirelessly to keep our streets passable, but while the salt helps us, it's also a big weight on the environment.
In general, we're going to have higher concentrations, probably higher in the watersheds where we have, you know, smaller bodies of water, less dilution.
Brian Bowl works for the Hamilton County Conservation District and twice a month takes readings from local rivers and streams.
The conductivity here today is 2.91 millisiemens per centimeter, a little bit high here.
The easiest way to measure salt content is through conductivity. The higher the conductivity, in general, the more salt is in the water.
Where there is direct snow melt runoff, we can see conductivity levels in 3 to 4 times or even sometimes 10 times higher than natural background concentrations.
And in those cases, freshwater streams are turned into a salty brine, affecting reproduction of fish and in some cases kill off other aquatic organisms. There is some good news. Through technology, alternative solutions are coming into play, but they're expensive. So for the time being, salt is still the best solution we have.